was told to give a quick khatira today. So, alhamdulillah, we all get blessed with a fajr prayer. So, I decided to reflect a little more about fajr. Not just because it's a special prayer for me, but I think it's a special prayer for all of us, right? So what is fajr? You know, fajr is the first prayer of the day. Fajr is an exchangeable name with Salat al-Subh. So if you say Salat al-Subh and Salat al-Fajr, you still cannot go wrong. And what is the word fajr in Arabic, right? So the word fajr in Arabic is, the original for it is from infijar, an explosion. And what we're talking about is when the sun comes up in the morning, right? In the middle of the darkness of the night, that sun is giving a lot of light, which is causing that explosion. And that's the name of the Salat al-Fajr. And then there is a lot involved with the Salat al-Fajr. A hadith, too many hadith related to Salat al-Fajr. Rak'atay al-Fajr khayrun min ad-dunya wa ma fiha. The two rak'at that you praying before Fajr, we're not even at the Fajr level yet. But the two rak'ah that we just prayed, the sunnah that we prayed before the fajr, is better than this entire life. Whoa, this is requiring a stop. So it is a two rak'ah that we pray sunnah. Anyone knows? We use a sunnah in the sunnah. What does that mean? It means that the Prophet ﷺ, when he prayed rak'atay al-fajr, the sunnah of the fajr, he prayed it exactly in the same way, reciting after al-Fatiha in the first rak'ah, Surah al-Kafirun, Qul ya ayyuha al-Kafirun. And in the second rak'ah, he's also always reciting Qul huwa al-Ahad, Surah al-Ikhlas. Can you pray saying anything? Yes, you can. But might as well, if you're following the sunnah, let's have the intention to follow the sunnah all the way. Two small surah, there is wisdom behind it. The ultimate tawheed, the ultimate once believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is between those two surah. And then there is a preparation part of the fajr, right? Because before the fajr, there is a isha prayer from the day before. And we know also in another hadith that من صلى العشاء في جماعة فكأنما قام نصف الليل ومن صلى الفجر في جماعة فكأنما قام الليل كله. Whoever pray Isha in congregation, in a jama'a, in group, as if he actually stand making qiyam half of the night, and whoever pray Isha and Fajr, as if you stand the entire night. Well, there's a lot of way encouraging us to come and pray Fajr. And there's another hadith that said, من صلى البردين دخل الجنة. البردين is Salat al-Fajr and Salat al-Asr this time. So Salat al-Fajr is still involved in this hadith, that if you pray those two prayer, you're going to go to heaven. This is great. And there's another hadith that says, من صلى الفجر في جماعة فهو في ذمة الله. Do we realize what dhimmatillah mean? You've been guarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're under His care for that day when you pray Fajr. You see how lucky we are when we get up in the morning and you just decide to come here. But then you get upset. And I'll tell you, I'm going to share with you why I get upset. I get upset because Fajr in Ramadan, how big Fajr in Ramadan? Anyone knows? We got a lot of lines during Fajr and Ramadan, right? But that's not repeated. This is just unique for Ramadan. Well, why if people can come in Fajr in the entire month of Ramadan that they don't come now? Allahu A'lam, they get their own reason, they get their own excuses. But you happen to be blessed among those people that you actually get up in the morning and manage to be here. So, with all of the benefits of the Fajr, what kind of precautions that you should be taking to continue coming over praying the Fajr, right? So there's common sense precautions that we, for example, we sleep early, right? So pray Isha and, you know, maybe not staying late will help us to wake up in the morning. So that's a precaution. Some of us will even set your alarm on, you know, Some of us may be a little struggling, we'll have more than one alarm because do you really care? But how about dua? Ever thought about just making a dua? So I was talking to one of the brothers and we were talking about his hajj, his trip to make the pilgrimage. And he said, I was invited, the term that he used, he said, I was invited to be a part of the hajj. Do you ever think that you were actually invited to be a part of the Fajr prayer? And how I get this invitation? Do you ask for the invitation? Can you make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes you can, make the standing in the morning, the waking up in the morning, a part of your ability to actually pray Fajr? We should also take the part. So back in my younger days, 20 years ago, in a place they call it Masjid al-Tawheed in Jersey City, New Jersey. And so the Imam had a little task for each one of us. The task is, you're going to be appointed as an Amir, a person in charge, not a prince in a perfect translation in Arabic, but the Amir in here is used as a person in charge. And he divide us to groups of people, right? So each Amir is the person in charge of 5 or 6 people. And that Amir's job is to wake up in the morning, a little earlier, right? And make phone calls or send text message to make sure that certain people are awake. Are you coming to Fajr today? You know, are you awake? And when they get the text message back, oh yeah, they awake, alhamdulillah. Oh, maybe they don't get the text message, you make a phone call for them. Just want to make sure that you're coming to Fajr day. And the place, the masjid, it starts filling up with people in the morning. I'm saying this because to share with you, there is a lot of benefits of the Fajr. If you look around in the age group that we have in this room, we get the younger people and we get the older people. I'm one of the older people, by the way. I'm not making fun of the older people, so alhamdulillah. So when I was in Egypt a little over a month ago, I was praying in a masjid, and the masjid was almost like half kilometer, a little less than half a mile away from where I was staying. And so take a walk to the masjid and just go there to pray. And I noticed something in Egypt, not a good thing, but Allahu A'lam, people get their own excuses. The only people who were praying Fajr in Egypt, and you notice there's something that you call Ahl al-Fajr. Look around, those faces here are repeated, right? I have seen you guys before, right? You can say that, because those are almost the same people that they pray Fajr every day. So in Egypt, you don't go to pray Fajr unless you're the old man. The old man who starts, you know, getting to the closing chapter of his life, right? That you know, I'm getting old, so let me get my hajj out of the way because I waited that long till I get old. And a part of getting the hajj out of the way, well, I'm getting old, so let me get my fajr prayer straight. So in Egypt, the entire first line of the masjid was chairs. Because most of the older people that they were actually coming in to pray Fajr, they wanted to sit down. As much as you can do, and I'm not saying this, I'm not aware of anyone's health condition, but I'm telling you this from my own experience, and I'm going to pass this to you. As much as you can do, try not to sit down. Yes, we all get our own reasons to sit down, and maybe we cannot make the ruku' and this knee is getting a little stiffer when I'm getting older, and this is totally understandable. But a doctor actually did a whole research in this, and he said that when you sit down, especially in that position, when you're making tashahud in the salah, it's actually keeping your knees flexibility, and you should be encouraged even to sit down in that position to help your body actually healing. One last thing, and I'm going to let you go, inshallah, after that. That another doctor did a whole research, and his research was about the timing for a stroke, a brain stroke or a heart stroke. And he said that timing for a stroke is almost around 8 o'clock in the morning for those who actually might have the risk of stroke. And he said that there is one way to beat the timing, to avoid the stroke every night. And the recipe that he gives to those people to avoid the stroke is what? Waking up earlier, before the 8 o'clock time, before your deadline of the 8 o'clock, wake up early and take a walk for half an hour before you go to sleep again, if you want to go to sleep again. Isn't that amazing? When you pray Fajr, the only adhan in Fajr is the adhan that tell you as-salatu khayrun min an-nawm. Did you try to reflect on this? Praying time in the Fajr is better than sleeping. And then you get a doctor doing a whole research about it. So I encourage myself and you to keep coming, inshallah, to Salat al-Fajr. Come as early as you can. Remember, Allah swore with the Fajr in Surah al-Fajr, wal-Fajr, wal-Layal al-Ashr. Remember that wa Qur'an al-Fajr, inna Qur'an al-Fajr kana mashhuda, that this Qur'an that the Imam Jazallah Khair recited now is actually witnessed. Remember that the time of the Fajr and the time of the Asr, the Bardain in the Hadith, من صلى البردين دخل الجنة, is the time that we actually an exchanging of the shift of the angel at the same time. And this is all witnessed by angel. It's how honored you are today. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم.
جزاكم الله خير.